The only thing worse than not being able to become pregnant is conceiving and then having a miscarriage. About 5% of couples will have two miscarriages in a row. 1% will have three or more miscarriages. These couples are referred to as having recurrent miscarriage or recurrent pregnancy loss. Couples with two or more unexplained miscarriages should have testing to look for possible causes. But which tests should you have? Stay tuned. First, it is important to understand that most miscarriages are not caused by abnormalities in either the male or female parent. Most miscarriages occur because of abnormalities in the embryo. These abnormalities might randomly originate from a specific egg or sperm or occur at or shortly after fertilization. For example, the majority of miscarriages occur when an embryo is formed. Most miscarriages occur from embryos that had an extra or missing chromosome when they were formed. Rarely, in less than 5% of couples with recurrent miscarriage, one of the parents might have an abnormality in their chromosomes called a translocation. Therefore, one test that couples with recurrent miscarriage should have is a blood test to look at their chromosomes. The remainder of the diagnostic tests for recurrent miscarriage are performed on the female partner only. Blood tests to look for a problem with the immune system called anti-phospholipid antibodies should be performed. There are three different blood tests you need to assess for anti-phospholipid antibodies. Unfortunately, the names of these tests are long and complicated. Here are the three tests. Number one, lupus anticoagulant. Number two, anticardiolipin antibody panel. And number three, beta 2 glycoprotein. If any of these tests were to come back abnormal, they should be repeated after 12 weeks to make sure they are persistently abnormal. Why? Very commonly, people can have a sporadic abnormal result. People with a sporadic result are not at increased risk for miscarriage and do not need any special treatment. Women should also have testing to look for uterine abnormalities. There are several tests that can be used to identify these abnormalities. The two tests that are used most commonly and are relatively inexpensive and easy to do are diagnostic hysteroscopy and saline ultrasound. During hysteroscopy, a fiber optic telescope is inserted into the uterine cavity. One advantage of this test is that some problems can be fixed at the same time as the test. Saline ultrasound involves filling the uterus with salt water and performing a transvaginal ultrasound at the same time. The salt water expands the uterine cavity, enabling the doctor to identify problems that can be missed with ultrasound alone. Other tests, like the HSG or hysterosalpingogram, may be chosen if a couple is also having infertility, since it will also show whether the fallopian tubes may have become blocked. Tests such as MRI are expensive and should not be used routinely. When evaluating the uterus, it is probably reasonable to do a biopsy to look for inflammation in the uterine lining. This is known as chronic endometritis. There have been a number of tests that were commonly performed in the past for couples with recurrent miscarriage that are no longer recommended. Why are they no longer recommended? Easy. Over time, better, larger studies were performed. Sometimes these better studies convincingly demonstrated that our initial data was incorrect or inaccurate. What are examples of tests for recurrent miscarriage that, based on more recent strong evidence, should not be performed in women with recurrent miscarriage? Blood tests for genetic variations in the MTHFR gene. Blood tests for several blood clotting problems, such as mutations in the factor 5 or factor 2 gene, or imbalances in the level of clotting factors, such as protein C, protein S, or antithrombin 3. Blood tests to look for antibodies to the thyroid gland. Blood tests or endometrial biopsies to look for elevated NK cells. Finally, there are some tests that may still be performed, but the studies backing them up are not strong. Blood tests to measure homocysteine levels or levels of a protein called PI1 or even vitamin D deficiency may have some benefit. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: the medical field is constantly changing. There are less tests recommended for recurrent miscarriage than there were in the past. Make sure that your doctor is up to date on the most recent data. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, IVF1.com, where you can become a patient.